Hello everyone, welcome to this Swift and Xcode tutorial. My name's Cal, and in today's tutorial we're going to be learning about local notifications. There are two types of notifications. Local notifications, which are really good for things like calendar events, reminder apps that are sort of easily predictable and are just within the app. And then the second kind, which we're not going to delve into today, are push notifications, which require a server to sort of push the information. Most of the work today is centered around actually just getting permission from the user to push notifications, and if you don't have permission, what to do and how to handle it. But yeah, let's get started. Cool, so we're just going to create a new Xcode project. This is an iOS app. I'm just going to call this notifications tutorial, next and create. We're going to head into the main storyboard. I'm going to drag in a couple of text fields. So I've just gone to add a new component. I've searched for text field and I'm just dragging them onto the default view controller. We're also going to drag in a date picker. So just setting that below, as well as a button. Cool. Next, we're going to add some constraints. So I'm just going to give it top space, center horizontally, and equal width. And then I'm just going to change proportional width to 0.8, meaning that our text field will take up 80% of our view controller. Next, we're going to head in and just give our text field some placeholder text. So just giving this one title. Our next text field, we're just going to set it below our title text field, giving it exactly the same constraints as our title text field. Placeholder text is going to be message, and just making the proportional width 1. We're going to set our date picker below our second text field. We're going to give it exactly the same constraints again. Finally, we're just going to set our button just below our date picker, make the text size a little bit bigger, and rename the text to schedule. Cool, next we're going to open up our assistant editor. We're going to create some outlets. So first thing we're going to do is right click and drag below our view did load and create an action. I'm just calling it schedule action. And then we're going to create an outlet for our date picker, just calling it date picker. Both of our text fields, the first one I'm just calling message text field and title text field. We can close that off now and head into our viewcontroller.swift. First thing we're going to do is import user notifications. And then we're just going to create a variable calling it notification center is equal to UN notification center, and then just calling current. So we're going to use this notification center in both of our functions. So that's why we're just declaring it here. And the first thing we're going to do is in our viewDidLoad, we're going to ask the user for permission to send local notifications. So we're just going to call notification center request authorization, and then options, I'm going to give it alert and sound. We're asking for permission to display alerts and play some sound. And next we want to fill in our completion handler. It's going to take two variables. The first one is Boolean, which is permission granted. And the second one is any errors that happened. And so what you can do in here is say if permission is not granted, maybe you need to disable some fields or whatever, but I'm just going to print permission denied, as we're actually going to do most of our validation on whether or not we've got permission in our schedule action. So yeah, what we're going to do is just call notificationcenter.getNotificationSettings, naming our completion handler variable settings. Inside here, we're going to say if settings authorization status is equal to authorized, meaning the user has given us permission to send local notifications. We're going to say let content equal to UN mutable notification content. We're going to give it content title is equal to, we're actually going to declare this at the top. We're going to say let title equal to title text field dot text, and then let message equal to message text field dot text. And we're just going to set our content title to our title and our content body to our message. And then we just need to give it an exclamation mark to force unwrap, as well as calling self. Finally, we're going to declare one more variable. We're going to call it date, which is equal to our self date picker.date. And then we're just going to say let date components equal to calendar current date components. And we need pretty much all of the date components. So I'm just calling year, month, day, hour, and minute. And from our date is our date that we created at the top. And then we're going to say let trigger equal to UN calendar notification trigger, date matching our date components and repeats is false. I'm going to say let request equal to UN notification request. For our identifier, we're just going to call UID and then just calling UID string. So that just creates a unique string. Our content is going to be our content and our trigger will be our trigger. Next, we're just going to call self notification center add request with a completion handler of an error. We're going to say if error is not equal to nil, meaning that there is an error, we're going to print out that error message as well as just returning. But if we make it pass there and there's no error, we're going to create an alert dialog, just calling it AC is equal to a UI alert controller. We're going to give it a title of notification scheduled, our message at, and give it our time. And our preferred style is going to be alert. Let's create just a quick function to get our date into a readable string. We're just going to call it formatted date, which receives a date and returns a string. We're going to say let formatter equal to date formatter. And our formatted date format is going to be days, months, years, hours, and minutes, but you could really choose whatever you like here. And then return formatter string from date and giving it our date. Now in our message, we can just call at plus our formatted date. We can remove this extra UI alert controller, hit fix to add self in front of our formatted date. Next, we're going to add an action to our alert controller. So I'm just going to say add action
giving it a UI alert action, a title of OK, style default, and nil for our handler. So just hitting enter and then backspacing that there. And then we're going to say self present AC, animated is true. And we can actually copy and paste this down into our else statement, because if the user hasn't given us permission to send local notifications, we need to tell them that, hey, if you want to use this feature, you need to enable notifications. So we're just changing the messages, but we also need to create an action to allow them to go to the settings. So we're just going to create a variable calling it go to settings equal to UI alert action. Our title, we're just going to give it settings. Style is default. This one is going to need a handler, so we're just going to hit enter, giving it an underscore. We're going to say guard let settings URL equal to URL, giving it the string of UI application.open settings URL string, and then just an else we're going to return. So if we can't find that, we're just going to return. And then we're going to say if UI application shared can open URL, giving it our settings URLs, meaning that we can open our settings URL. We're going to say UI application shared open, giving it our settings URL. We're going to remove options and our completion handler. We're just going to not do anything. And then we're just going to say AC add action and giving it our go to settings. And if we scroll back up, we're getting error messages saying that views should only be modified from the main thread. To fix this, we just need to say dispatch queue main async, put all of our code inside this to say we're going to put this on the main thread. Cool. And if we build and run this now, you can see once we've opened the app, our view did load code has run and it's asking us permission to send local notifications. We're going to hit don't allow to test our settings URL. So we're just going to hit settings. We're going to allow notifications, head back into the app, set the time a little bit into the future, fill in our notification title and message, and then just hit schedule. And if we close off the app and wait until it's time for our notification, you can see it's popped up there with our message and our title. So yeah, that's how you send local notifications in Swift and Xcode. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.